Hi everyone, in this chapter we will explore why selectors are necessary and how to simplify the first level selection process. Let's turn our attention to the cat box component. Let's go to the code. Here we see we use the selectors. Since we use all the states, we can just simplify the code in this way. Here we can comment out. So this will also work. The code is more simple and clear. And this also works. But this is only good in case you need all the elements from the store. If you only need a part of elements, then this is not good because it will cause unnecessary render. Let me show you an example. We create a new component called catbox2. And I just copy the code here. In this catbox2, I only use the bigger cats, but I still call it with useCatStore. This is very comfortable for us to write codes. Let's embed our catbox2 to the app. Now let's go to the website to have a check. Add a big cat, add a big cat, add a small cat. So far, everything seems to be in order. However, how can we determine whether the component has been rendered? The simplest approach is to include a random number generating function within our component. Let's go back to catbox. And here we add mass.random. And let's also go to the catbox2 mass.random. Okay, now let's have a check. So we see here is a random number. Here is also a random number. Every time if the component is rendered, then the number will change. Let's add a big cat. Correct. Both sides are rendered. Add big cats. Correct. Now let's add small cats. You see, both sides also changed. So in the left cat box, it's correct because small cats changed. But on the right side, there is no small cats. The component is still rendered. So this poses a problem. When your app becomes larger, the speed will slow down. This is the reason why we need the selector. Now, let's try to use the selector to call the big cat state in catbox2. Big cats is equal to use cat store. Here is the selector callback function, state return state.cats.bigcats. Okay, let's go to the website, have a check. Add big cats, both sides re-rendered. And let's try add small cats. You see? Here only the left side, the cat box re-rendered, but the right side didn't change. However, if you need a lot of states from a store, it can become cumbersome. Fortunately, in the Zustand documentation, the author has provided a small piece of code that allows you to simplify the first level selector. Just go to here. So the documentation of the Zustand library, and here under the auto generating selectors. Here create the following function, create selectors. We just copy this code and create a utility file. Create selectors, .ts. Then we just paste the code here. And here is some warning from ESLint. So we just change the let to const. Here is also the same. And also don't forget here export. Okay, this code simply takes a hook store and extend it a use property. This use property takes all the keys of the states. And the corresponding selector function as value. Then return the store. Now let's go back to our cat store, use this piece of code. The usage is really simple. Just wrap our use cat store. So use our smart selection, control shift, write parentheses, and then create selectors. So that's all. Now let's just take a look at the newly created use cat store. We just use cat store dot. Then we will see it has a use property, and the use property has all the states. Okay, now let's create a new component called cat controller. In the cat controller, I paste the code from my notes. This is a component which contains two functions. One is increase big cats, and the other is increase small cats. And here I use the old method to call the two functions. And here is a math random to take a look whether it's rendered. Now, let's go to our app and import this cat controller. Let's add a big cat. So the big cat is not called, but it's still rendered. And the same for add small cats. So it's not what we want. Now let's go to our cat controller and call the two functions in the new way. Const increase big cats is equal to use cat store dot use dot increase big cats. But keep in mind we here need the parentheses because in our create selector the value is a function. So we need here also a parenthesis to call this function. And the same here, increase small cats is equal to use cat store dot use increase small cats. Okay, now let's go to our website, refresh, and here add big cats. See? It's not rendered. And also add small cats. Here also not rendered. This is cool, but we still need to take care. In the cat box 2 here, we cannot use the auto-generated selector. Let's go to cat box 2 here, because the use cat store dot use dot, it can only return the first level states. So we cannot do this. Okay, in this video, we learned why we need the selector and how to create auto generator for our selector. In the next video, we will learn the multi-state selector and the Shenlong function.